super blessed. We had a 429 bushel no-till irrigated entry this year. Pretty good. Yeah, 2011 was a lot like 2010 in that we had a nice warm spring, so we had really good, quick, even emergence. So that helped out. We had a really good foundation. And then throughout the year, we started to get some timely rains in the springtime and kind of gave our corn plant off to a good start. And it's in the irrigated environment, so we're not too worried about whether we get the rainfall. But what we really saw this year compared to 2007 was we had a whole lot of sunlight. It seemed like it really only rained at nighttime. We didn't have the really hot temperatures that we had out in the Midwest as much. So we were in the 90s. Occasionally we saw 100 degrees, but anytime it got really hot, we went to an advanced irrigation and cooled the corn down. So we had a lot of sunlight. That's something we haven't had and we can't control. And then, you know, come harvest time, it came off a little earlier. Thank goodness, because we were harvesting corn right in front of a hurricane. Well, this past year, we were introduced to a Pioneer variety, 2088 HR. So the HR, you gave us some insect control, and also Roundup resistant. It's 120-day corn, so that was a little bit long season for us, so we were kind of skeptical there. But the researchers and their seed Pioneer guys suggested that, hey, it's got great plant health, good emergence, and it's got good stay green. So that's something we look for to try to pack as much energy we can to get into that kernel. So, you know, they suggested that it may be somewhat moderate in test weight. Well, we knew that if we could get a good, healthy crop, good stay good, we could pack energy into that kernel, and we did. The traditional agriculture logs, you know, we use a lot of starter fertilizer because we're in a continuous no-till program. We have a Chesapeake Bay, so we got a lot of water quality issues. So we can't just put out fertilizer in the fall or pre-plant and expect it to be there because it's a leach or we have environmental concerns. So we do not spoon feed, but we try to time our applications in advance so it's not lacking. So we do some starter fertilizer, we do some mop up, side dressing, and then we add some other products like some sugar, just some regular old cane sugar. You know, add that. And the plant needs energy. The soil is living, so we need stuff like that to help feed the soil microbes. So that's just something far-fetched somebody may think. Pretty simple, inexpensive, and it's both benefit both the plant as well as the soil. This past year, we did some really late nitrogen applications. You know, when I say late, kind of near just before tasseling. We kind of like what we saw there. It's part of a system. We don't have a magic bullet. Everybody says, what are you doing? Well, from the time we open the bag to the time we plant corn or harvest corn, that's the whole system. So we're just tweaking that system a little bit. Some of the things we kind of try to trick the plant to think differently, because all a corn plant wants to do is make one kernel of corn and it's successful. Well, we don't want to make one. We want it to make up to 900 kernels per year. So that's something we're just trying to trick.